Hey, you weird war weirdos, it's Brian again, and it's Monday, so that means another episode of Shit on My Table. Alright guys, we're going diving into German vehicle box number deuce, so let's check it out. Alright guys, so this is everything in this box. Alright, bunch of various stuff, straight historical prototypes, and weird war, so let's dive in and check it out. Okay, first thing we got some Panzer Ones. Woo, check those out for your early war. And I'm going to use these for my Chinese forces too. So it's pretty cool. Just dual machine guns. These are Blitzkrieg miniatures. These are resin. They're just cast resin, man. They're just like, it's the vehicle and the turret. That's it. They're really nice, man. These are 148 too. It's rare that you see 148 resins. Everybody does that stupid 156, but again, these are 148s, so I love them. Some more Blitzkrieg miniatures are here. These are 35Ts. These are those Czech tanks. Again, these are going to be, I guess they're L-47s or whatever, whatever the Czechs call them, but the Germans call them
35Ts. 35s, laser.
I guess T was the abbreviation for Czech vehicles for the German army. But anyway, but these are Blitzkrieg miniatures too. These are solid resin pieces, just two pieces. These are great. 148 scales again. Again, I'm going to use these for my early war Germans and my Chinese because I've got my weird World War II. There is a Škoda factory not Škoda. I can't remember who made them. I think Škoda made them. But anyway, there's a Czech factory in China that's producing 35Ts. So they're going to, the Chinese are going to have access to a lot of that shit. So the weird war stuff to get some cool shit into the campaign. Great looking models. Great looking stuff. See, look, I mean, even look at the tracks, man. That shit looks great. It's not like a lot of those resin ones. They look like ass. These really look really good. I'm impressed. All right, then here, check it out. We got the Mine Rammer. Ooh, look at that. This is a 148 scale model kit from Quarter Kit. Quarter Kit is a French model company, and they make 148 scale shit. And excellent model. This is all resin. Fantastic. I need to finish that. You know, of course, these aren't finished painted, so you're going to have to excuse that, but this is just a showcase to show you what kind of vehicles are out there and stuff that might get you motivated to buy some. Now, the Mine Rammer, a couple of these were made. They were supposed to, these big heavy wheels, these big metal plates were supposed to just detonate mines, and this thing it had like a V hole. Well, it had the hole, the lower superstructure was like in force, so it basically just drove over mines. And this was supposed to clear the minefields of the Soviets, but it was never deployed. There is one, I think there's one surviving in one of the Soviet museums, so that's pretty cool. It just came with a Panzer I turret, and there was also plans to put a Panzer II turret on there with the autocannon. Now these things make great, you know, if you just play them historically how they were meant to play, it would be great scenario trying to breach a minefield while being attacked. But these things also work fantastic against the zombie undead hordes. This thing's just laying waste, just crushing zombies. Woo, that's awesome. Then here we got just the 148 scale V1 rocket on its carriage. This is just used for scenery for the most part. I don't remember where I got this. I think I got this from a trade. I did a trade with somebody, and I got this and some vehicles. So it's pre-painted and everything. So it's a cool vehicle, or a cool piece of scenery to have in the background. And then over here, we got some 3D printed LWSs. These are these German amphibious tractors. Now, for like you guys who are playing like maybe like Operation Sea Lion or some shit, you could use these bad boys. These things could carry like 20, 30 troops, man. They're basically like a little boat, but they got tracks. So, awesome vehicles. Now, these are filamented print. I don't remember who I bought these from. they look like shit because I've been sanding on them, and you know that I need to, you know, I haven't painted them, but I think the details on these are pretty crisp and pretty strong, and I think these are going to look really fantastic when I finish painting them up. And they're big. Look at that. These are 1/48 scale ones. They're big, big chunky vehicles. I plan on doing some, like, I want to get a hold of the Warlords Operation Sea Lion book and play out those missions and stuff, but I haven't got that yet. But I plan on it. I'm going to use some of this stuff to reenact the actual bridge or the channel crossing. Instead of barges, they're going to have, like, a bunch of these fuckers. So it should be pretty cool. All right, then the rest that's in this box are dust stuff. So we got various dust vehicles here. I don't remember what this bad boy was called. The Hans, I think, maybe. It's like a light walker. And it's got, like, rockets, like anti-tank rockets. There's some, these flathead ones, those are fragmentation, and these are heat. So nice dual, you know, pretty much take down anything or anybody. Then we got, in my weird World War II, this model of Walker is like an early war because it's got riveted construction, and that riveted shit went out pretty quick when the conflict started. So I pretty much, in my own story, that these are the initial run of Walkers, and everything after these, you know, we're having plate armor and whatnot, welded armor. But we got a couple Ludwigs here. These are dual pack 40s. One's going to be for early war German, and the other one's like a, you know, Arctic. And then these are the Luthers. These have a mechanical fist, like a claw, and they've got 50 millimeter autocannons on them. Pretty sweet. And then these guys, these are the, Loths. These are like dual, like claws. They're meant to be like cargo or whatever, like, but you can use them in like close combat or whatever. That's pretty cool. And then the back, we got a Lothar.
Lothar of the Gael people.
Got himself a some rockets on it. But yeah, so, you know, this is what's great about Weird World War II, guys, is that, you know, it can be as weird as you want it. It can be, you know, mechs, you know, and crazy walkers and shit. Or it could be like the Chinese using, you know, 35Ts. Or, you know, prototype weapons that are actually being deployed. Or all of a sudden, the Germans have, like, you know, 5,000 of these fuckers instead of, like, 20 during Operation Sea Lion. And then you got a problem because your troops are able to deploy and then actually drive off the beach. So, yeah. So, you know, World War II allows you to do anything you want to do, guys. All right? So... don't be afraid. If you're a historical gamer, don't be afraid to walk out of the box every once in a while. You know, put away that, you know, walk away from those history books and kind of develop your own historical background and what if scenarios. And you just might have some weird war fun. All right, guys. So I hope you guys like that. Again, these showcases are meant for you guys to kind of see my collection. And also give you guys ideas on how to acquire this stuff. Now, again, Blitzkrieg miniatures are in the UK. So if you're a UK guy or gal, you have access to that shit. It's a little... now, Sherwood Forest, Sherwood Games in the States, they sell. They're like, I think they're Blitzkrieg's distributors. So in the States, so we can get access to this stuff. But, you know, a lot of times they're out of... you know, it seems like their restock kind of takes a while. But again, they've got stuff. So go over to Sherwood's link. I'll probably find a link and put it down there for you guys to check out. So definitely check that out. Swing by Quarter Kit. Again, if you're European, you guys are lucky because Quarter Kit is massive. Now, Quarter Kit is a model company. So their stuff is a little pricey because it's model grade and, like, you know, it's really intricate and detailed and whatnot. Now, I don't care. Like, I'm a wargamer at heart at first, but I love using models for my wargaming pieces, not just, you know, wargaming models, because they tend to lose detail, tend to lose some realism to them, just so they would make them easier to play with. But, you know, fuck it. The cool thing about armor is that if a piece breaks off, or, you know, something bends or whatever, it don't matter. That's how real tanks are, so you can get away with it. So, but yeah, and also dive into the eBay and look up these 3D printer guys. You know, they're printing up stuff, and a lot of times they'll sell a scale. Like, if you see a model that's like 156 or, you know, 172 or whatever it might be, talk to them. Shoot them a message and say, hey, man, is there any way you can up those scales or lower those scales or whatever you want to do? And usually they can. Usually, you know, it might be a couple extra bucks, or it might be cheaper, you know, if you want a smaller size. But don't forget, these 3D printing stuff can be altered in size. So don't be afraid if there's a seller to ask them. Just say, hey, I'm a 148, or, you know, I'm a 150 guy. Is there any way you can up or lower the scale for me? And, dude, they want the sale, and they'll pretty much bend over backwards to do so. So give them a go. All right, guys. Go out there and find some cool toys, all right? And whatever you do, keep it weird. See ya.